my grandpapa, to me, was an amazing fellow. I used to spend summer holidays with him, and I'd go and sit. He had an atelier. I'd sit beside him and watch him work on the watches, and he would pass some components. He said, "Go ahead, you can do like this, and look, look," and I would try to follow suit. I was brought up in France, did schooling in France and in Switzerland, and then went to America University. I worked in America for 5 years, lived another 3 years in New York City, and then 3 years in California, and then moved back to France, where I spent basically most of my life, except for the last 17 years that I've been now in Malaysia. So Malaysia is truly my second home. I was always passionate by mechanical things. Made model airplanes, model cars, different types of models. I was passionate about the radio control things. I had my own lathe when I was 14 years old and used to make parts. So I always liked the element of mechanical objects. As you can see behind me, there's a boat. I've always loved boats. I built five boats. And even here in Malaysia, I had two boats here in Malaysia, and used to keep one of them in Phuket, and the other one I kept over in this Port Klang. I had a partner who we did work together back in Europe, and we bumped into each other around 9 years ago, and we decided we should do something ourselves. So, hence the birth of Cecil Purnell, in honor of my grandpapa, who I used to go and see him work at his bench, you know, taking apart watches, putting together watches. Certainly I tried my hand in that. Oh, my grandpapa, to me, was an amazing fellow. He was on my maternal side. I used to spend summer holidays with him, and I'd go and sit. He had an atelier. I'd sit beside him and watch him work on the watches, and he would pass some components. He said, "Go ahead, you can do like this, and look, look," and I would try to follow suit. And then other moments that I had, you know, he'd take me walking on the beach. I remember those moments. He'd go fishing in the sea, you know, and I remember those moments with him. I remember moments where in the morning, you know, I would get in bed with him, sit beside him, my sister would be on the other side, and he'd read The Wizard of Oz. Wow, what an amazing book, you know. And as a child, you keep those memories in your mind. So he's somebody who, I say, gave me patience, you know. I learned patience from him. I learned the passion for, as I told you, mechanical objects from him, because he's the only one who ever gave me that joy or that thrill. But I think that a dream that I have, you know, for a company like Cecil Purnell is that, you know, we grow, we become better and better known, that discerning people who are, you know, watch aficionados, these people appreciate the amount of work and effort that goes into making our particular product. So we try to give to a collector the understanding that, number one, they might get a case which is very avant-garde, you know, and pushes the limits to what can be seen, but we try to keep with a tradition of how watchmakers were making watches 100 or 150 years ago. One of the things that you'll be seeing in the fair for this coming up event will be the uses of enamel and hand-painted. This is done the way watches were made 200 years ago. I think that it's good to have belief. Everybody needs that as a core value. I'd say the next most important thing is family. I mean, family is blood is thicker than water, as they say. And then the next most important thing that we have are friends and friendship. My hobby and my passion is also my children. I have a Malaysian wife. I have two young children. I love spending time with them. To me, it's like a breath of fresh air. I'd say that, to encapsulate from the amount of years that I have one single event, I'd have to say that probably my marriage to my wife, my birth of my children, and the brightness in their eyes, those are, to me, what moves me the most.